Hi everyone, marhaba, this is Shariq and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot with Arabic. This is going to be a Lebanese Arabic lesson dedicated to my Lebanese Arabic students. Before I begin, let me ask you to subscribe to my channel if you've been finding my lessons useful. Also follow me on Facebook and on Instagram because I also upload lessons there almost on a daily basis. So today's lesson is going to be about all the expressions, at least the ones I remember, all the expressions in Arabic that have the word heart, alib. We've done two lessons before. One of them was about all the expressions in Arabic that have the word ayn, eye, and the expressions that have the word head, ras. I will leave them in the description box below. Today we will do all the expressions, at least the ones that I remember, that have the word heart, alib. Heart. Let's begin. As I said, the word heart in Arabic means alb. Alb. That's in Lebanese Arabic. But in standard Arabic, it's pronounced as qalb. Qalb. We write it in the same way in Lebanese Arabic with the qaf in the beginning, qalb. But we don't pronounce it as qalb in Lebanese Arabic. We will pronounce it as alb, and that's the case with all the words that have the qaf, almost all the words that have the qaf in Lebanese Arabic. So qalb in standard Arabic and alb in Lebanese Arabic. So today's first expression is going to be ala albi mitl al asal. Ala albi mitl al asal. Ala literally means on. Alb means heart. Albi means my heart. Mitl means like, just like. And asal means honey. Il asal means the honey. Mitl al asal, literally you're saying like the honey, but you mean like honey. Ala albi, on my heart, like honey. When do you say this expression? You say this expression to someone maybe doing something a bit annoying to you, but because you love them so much, it's like honey to your heart. على قلبي مثل العسل. For example, if I love chocolate very much, which is true, and somebody came and ate all my chocolates. If it's usually another person who ate my chocolates, I would complain and I would say, why did he eat my chocolates and all of that. But if it's someone who I love and ate it, I would say, it's okay, he can eat all of it. And على قلبي مثل العسل. على قلبي مثل العسل. And you notice I'm not saying مثل العسل. I'm pronouncing it with a liaison. على قلبي مثل العسل. The next expression for today is just حيات قلبي. حيات قلبي. قلب means heart, قلبي means my heart, as you know, and حيات means life. So when you say to someone انت حيات قلبي, and if it's a woman you say انت حيات قلبي, it's a way to say you are the life to my heart, which means I love you very much. انت حيات قلبي. انت حيات قلبي. And sometimes I say to someone حيات قلبي انا, and I use the pronoun انا in the end. حيات قلبي انا. It's just we add it sometimes and sometimes we can drop it. So قلبي انا, it's like you're stressing the heart of mine, basically. حيات قلبي انا or حيات قلبي, just like that. And if, for example, the person I love, or any person, it doesn't have to be the person I'm in love with, it can be someone who is from my family or someone who's very dear, and they call my name, they say Shariq, for example, and I reply, my reply would be Shu ya albi, what my love? Shu, what? Ya, it's a way to address ourselves to people. The closest translation in English would be hey. It's not literally hey, but that's the closest translation to it. It's a way to call someone. Ya albi, hey, my heart. Shu ya albi, what, my heart. And this hey word, which is ya, as I told you before, it's not an informal word. You can use it really with anyone in a formal setting and in an informal setting with friends. So if somebody calls me and I love them very much, I say shu ya albi. Shu ya albi, what, my heart. It's a way to say, what do you want? I'm here. Shu ya albi. The next one is from the series of yabrni, yabrni tiza, which we did in another lesson, which I can also keep the link in the description box below. We have another one that goes yabr albi. يقبر قلبي, if I'm talking in general about someone, he يقبر قلبي, and if it's she, I say تقبر قلبي, and if I'm talking to you as a guy, I say تقبر قلبي, and if I'm talking to a girl, I would say تقبر قلبي, تقبر قلبي. What does this mean? Literally, يقبر or تقبر means to bury. To bury. When somebody's dead, you bury him. يقبر قلبي. It's a way to say, may he bury my heart. It's like you are saying, I love him so much that I want to die before him so he buries my heart. And that's why you say, يقبر قلبي. Let's repeat. So, if I'm talking about him, I say, يقبر قلبي. Usually we say this, for example, when it's a kid or a baby that we love so much, or maybe the person we love as well. But I personally use it with my nephews and nieces. So يقبر قلبي, like may he bury my heart, I love him so much. And if it's my niece, I say, if I'm talking to my sister, let's say she sent me a photo of, or something, I say تقبر قلبي, may she bury my heart, تقبر قلبي. And if I'm talking to the person directly, if it's a guy, I say تقبر قلبي. And sometimes I can say تقبر قلبي انت, I put the pronoun انت in the end. And if it's a woman, I can say تقبر قلبي or تقبر قلبي انت. The next expression is قلبه طيب, قلبه طيب. طيب means kind, or it also means tasty. When you say his heart is tasty, of course you don't mean tasty, but you mean he has a kind heart, he has a good heart. قلبه طيب, قلبه his heart, قلبه her heart, قلبه طيب, قلبه طيب. And if you want to say about yourself that you have a good heart, you say قلبه طيب, قلبه طيب. The next expression is سلامة قلبك, سلامة قلبك. So if somebody, for example, is sick or they are in the hospital or they are going through a problem or a difficult situation, usually we can say just سلامتك, سلامتك, your health, or سلامتك, your health or your safety basically. But if we want to be more warm, we say سلامة قلبك. It's a way to say the safety, literally the safety of your heart, or سلامة قلبك, the safety or the health of your heart, literally of your heart. But you mean may your heart be safe or may your heart be healthy. It's a way to say get well soon as well, okay? So سلامة قلبك and سلامة قلبك, may you get well soon. The next one is وقف قلبي, وقف قلبي. My heart stopped, as if it's a way to say I really got scared, or like you scared me, وقف قلبي, or something happened and I really really got scared and then I'm relaxed and I know nothing happened, so I say وقف قلبي. Okay, and sometimes in songs you see people say وقف قلبي, it's a way to say like my heart skipped the beat because, you know, I saw someone and my heart stopped, which means I really liked them or I loved them. The next expression, it's a word basically, and it means inside, بقلب. So for example, if there is a box and you say, for example, the pen is in the box, القلم بالعلبة, the pen is in the box. القلم be in ال the علبة box. But sometimes we can also say القلم بقلب, in the heart of, بقلب العلبة, pronounced with a liaison as بقلب العلبة, which means inside of, بقلب, simply. The next one is قلبي عم بيدق, my heart is beating. قلبي عم بيدق, بيدق means it beats, عم بيدق makes it present continuous and it means it is beating. قلبي عم بيدق, my heart is beating. It could be for two reasons, I'm very excited, I am scared, or I am very happy, or I'm in love with someone and I'm in a situation where I'm gonna see him or something. I can say قلبي عم بيدق. Sometimes we also say قلبي عم بيدق بسرعة, قلبي عم بيدق بسرعة, literally with speed, ب with سرعة means speed. But when I'm saying it faster, I don't say قلبي عم بيدق بسرعة, no, with the liaison we say قلبي عم بيدق بسرعة, قلبي عم بيدق بسرعة. انت دايما بالقلب، انت دايما بالقلب. دايما means always، انت means you in the masculine. We know that انت is feminine. انت دايما بالقلب. You are always in the heart. When I say in the heart, I mean in my heart, of course. But sometimes we use it as in the heart. Generally speaking, انت دايما بالقلب. You're always in the heart, which means you're always in my heart. وانت دايما بالقلب. You're always in my heart. It's a way to say you're always on my mind. Personally, I think there is a small difference between saying انت دايما بقلبي or انت دايما بالقلب. I think when we say انت دايما بقلبي, it's more personal and warmer. You're saying it's in my heart. But when I say to someone, generally speaking, انت دايما بالقلب, you're always on the mind, it's a bit more distant, not formal, but a bit more distant, and sometimes maybe it is said out of politeness. Okay, so انت دايما بالقلب. انت دايما بالقلب. The next expression is ما إلي قلب. ما إلي قلب. ما إلي, I don't have. إلي is I have. ما إلي, I don't have. ما إلي قلب, I don't have a heart. What does this mean? It doesn't mean I literally don't have a heart. No, but it's a way to say I feel sorry for someone and I don't want to do that. If I have a kid and he did something wrong and I want to punish him and I feel sorry for him at the same time, so I say ما إلي قلب, ما إلي قلب, I don't have a heart. Okay, this is a fixed expression. It doesn't change whether you're talking about a boy or a girl because it's about you. ما إلي قلب, I don't have a heart. The next expression is كيف إلك قلب. كيف إلك قلب. كيف, how. إلك, you have, literally means for you. How, for you. كيف إلك, that's masculine. And if it's feminine, it's كيف إليك. كيف إلك or كيف إليك. كيف إلك قلب, how do you have a heart, and كيف إليك قلب, how do you have a heart in the feminine form. It doesn't literally mean that. It's a way to say how can you do that, how do you have the courage to do that, and how come you don't feel sorry for the other person. Okay, كيف إلك قلب. Maybe for example your child or your kids was naughty and you want to punish them, and maybe you're not giving them chocolate or something and they cry a lot, and then maybe I am your friend and I tell you it's okay, just give it to him. And I can sometimes say كيف إلك قلب or كيف إليك قلب, like how can you do it. قلبي مليان منك. قلبي, my heart, مليان is full, مليان. قلبي مليان, my heart is full, منك, literally from you. And if you're talking to a woman, you say قلبي مليان منك, my heart is full from you, literally. What does this mean? It means like I'm really, like you made me so sad, not once, not twice, many times, like I'm fed up with you, basically. I'm fed up, قلبي مليان منك. And it's not just fed up like in a negative way, it's a way to say like I'm really sad in a way, you know, when I say to someone قلبي مليان منك, like I'm upset with you as well. Okay, the next one is قلبي انجرح. قلبي, my heart, انجرح. انجرح means it was literally wounded, got wounded. So قلبي انجرح, it's a way to say to someone you hurt me and you hurt my heart. قلبي انجرح. You can also say قلبي محروق. محروق means burned. قلبي محروق, my heart is burned. It's a way to say also that, you know, you feel really sad about something, or maybe you really wanted something and it didn't happen, so you say قلبي محروق. قلبي انجرح, my heart was wounded, which means it's still wounded basically. قلبي انجرح or قلبي محروق. You could also say قلبي مجروح. In that case, you're using the participle as well. Instead of saying قلبي انجرح, my heart got wounded, you can say قلبي مجروح. It's used as an adjective. So my heart is wounded, basically. If you want to say from all my heart, we say the same in Arabic. من كل قلبي. من, from, كل, all, قلب, heart, قلبي, my heart. من كل قلبي. من كل قلبي. If you want to say to someone, I love you from all my heart. بحبك من كل قلبي. قلبي حسنة. قلبي حسنة. Literally, my heart felt, حسنة, felt me. It's not literally like that, but when I say albi hasne, it's like you're saying, I knew it, or I knew it's gonna happen. And it's like a way to say, you know, you have sixth sense and you knew something's gonna happen. So albi hasne, albi hasne. And similar to this expression, sometimes we say albi l'im, literally alb l'im. Alb means heart, l'im, the mother. The heart of a mother, قلب الأم. So when I say just قلب الأم on its own as an expression, it means a mother's heart always has sixth sense or knows something's gonna happen before it happens. So that's قلب الأم. So قلب حسني, my heart felt it, which means I knew it, or قلب الأم. الم. And if you want to say that someone is very courageous and strong and sometimes determined, so that's قلب الأسد, like they are not scared of anything. قلب الأسد. أسد means lion. الأسد means the lion. قلب الأسد, the heart of a lion. قلب الأسد. So I can say to someone, قلبه قلب أسد. His heart is a heart of lion. قلبه قلب أسد. And if you're saying about a woman, you say Alba, her heart, Alba Alb Asad. She's really strong, she's really courageous, she doesn't fear anything. And when I say Ide a Albi, Ide, my hand, a on Albi, literally, you know, when you're waiting for a result of something, when you're worried, when you're scared, you sometimes put your hand on your heart. Ide a Albi. So that's where the expression comes from. It's like you're waiting for some news and you're worried and you want to know if the news is positive or negative. So you say, I'm really scared, I'm really worried. Okay, so that's ايدي عقلبي. نشف قلبي. نشف قلبي. نشف means it dried out. قلبي, you know, now it's my heart. نشف قلبي, my heart dried out. It's a way to say I completely am so tired. Someone sucked my energy completely. So that's نشف قلبي. Like you have no words to express how tired you are, basically. So that's نشف قلبي, which means literally he dried out my heart. نشف قلبي. It can be used in two ways. نشف قلبي, he dried my heart out, or my heart dried out. نشف قلبي. It's a way to say my heart is dry. Okay, so نشف قلبي. The next one is تركت بقلبي, or تركت بقلبي. تركت is I left. تركت, I left it or her. Or تركت, I left it or him, if it's a masculine object or an idea or something. تركت بقلبي. So maybe if it depends on what you're saying. So for example, if it's something you wanted to say to someone and you never said it to him, you say تركت بقلبي. I left it in my heart. I kept it as a secret and I never told him. Or it's another way to say also, like you didn't express your feelings or emotions and you kind of closed yourself. So that's تركت بقلبي. تركت بقلبي. I'm not saying تركت بقلبي, I could, but it's nicer if you pronounce it تركت بقلبي. The next expression is قلبي عليك. قلبي عليك. My heart literally is on you. على means on. على. But when I say on you, I don't say عليك. No, I pronounce it عليك. قلبي عليك. And if it's feminine, you say قلبي عليك. When you say قلبي عليك or قلبي عليك, it's a way to say I'm worried about you, I care about you. That's why I'm giving you this advice, for example. قلبي عليك or قلبي عليك. There is a nice Lebanese song from Ziad Bourgi. I will put it in the description box down below. It's called أنا قلبي عليك. And he pronounces it as أنا قلبي عليك, which is correct. Sometimes I say أنا قلبي عليك or أنا قلبي عليك. عليك. Two different ways of saying the same word, basically. So قلبي عليك, I worry about you, I care about you. The next expression is ريب قلبك. Read, literally, ري, ري. That's the imperative form of to read. ريب قلبك. ريب قلبك, literally read in your heart. It's a way to say don't read out loud, read Do you say it in English in your heart or with your eyes? Like, not out loud, basically, okay? So that's ri b'albak. You can also say, I read it in my heart, rit b'albi, like I didn't read it out loud, rit b'albi. And sometimes you also say, ilta b'albi, ilt, I said, ilta, I said it, ilta b'albi. It's a way to say, I said it in my heart, but I didn't say it out loud, okay? So, ilta b'albi. So, rit b'albi, I read in my heart, which means I didn't read out loud. Ilta b'albi, I said it in my heart. And if you want to say to someone, read in your heart, like a teacher maybe wants to say to her student, don't read out loud, just try to read with your eyes. So she would say, ri b'albak, if she's saying it to a boy, ri b'albik, if she's saying it to a girl. And if she wants to say it to a group, she would say, ru b'albkon, because ri, that's masculine and feminine imperative. Ru is the plural form, so rub albkun, read with your eyes, basically. Okay, the next one is albu kbir. Albu kbir, albu or alba, kbir, big. Her heart is big, or his heart is big. It's a way to say, just like in English, he has a big heart or she has a big heart. And also we use it when a person is loving, tolerant, kind, and all of that. Now we have the other expression. We use it most of the times as a joke. Elbo or Elba, her heart is, or his heart. Elbo is his heart, Elba is her heart. Elbo kbir bisi'a mit mhab. Elbo kbir bisi'a mit mhab. And if we're talking about a woman, we say Elba kbir bisi'a mit mhab. And if I'm saying the sentence about myself, is Elbe kbir بِسَاعَ مِيت مْحَبْ. Let's translate it first of all, word by word. أَلْبُ كبير, literally, his heart is big. أَلْبُ, his heart, بير, big. بِسَاعَ means it fits. أَلْبُ كبير بِسَاعَ مِيت مْحَبْ. مِيَة in Arabic means 100. مْحَبْ means lovers or people you love, basically. مِيت مْحَبْ, I'm not saying مِيَة بْحَبْ. Why? Because we have here مِيَة, it's followed by a noun, مْحَبْ. So I don't say مِيَة مْحَبْ, I pronounce the تِ مَرْبُوتَة and I say مِيَّة مْحَبْ. And most of the times when we are pronouncing it fast, instead of saying مِيَّة مْحَبْ, we pronounce it مِيت مْحَبْ. مِيت مْحَبْ, 100 lovers. Okay, albu kbir bisi' mit mhab. His heart is big, it fits 100 lovers. When do you say this? It's a way to say a guy goes out with so many girls, or somebody who is promiscuous. Okay, so that's when you say it, albu kbir bisi' mit mhab. Now we have a very similar expression that has a completely different meaning. We say albayt kbir بِسَاعَ مِيت مْحَبْ. البيت, the house. البيت كبير, the house is big. البيت كبير بِسَاعَ مِيت مْحَبْ. The house is big and it fits, or it can accommodate, basically. It can accommodate مِيت مْحَبْ, 100 people we love. It's a way to say our house is always open to the people we love, and we are generous, and anyone can come and everybody's welcome. Okay, so that's البيت كبير بسيع ميت محب. But when I say البو كبير or البا كبير بسيع ميت محب, we are talking about someone who loves to go out with more than one person, or is even promiscuous, or even if the person is not like that, we use it most of the times as a joke. So, you know, for example, if I, for example, told one of my friends, oh, I really like this guy, and then 5 minutes later I said to them, oh, you know what, this guy is cute, or, and then I talk about another guy, they can tell me, شو قلبك كبير بساعة ميت محب, like your heart is big and it can fit 100 lovers. It's not, they don't mean I am promiscuous, but they say, like, you are talking about so many guys. Okay, so that's قلبي كبير بسيع ميت محب. I said it to you in a previous lesson, when we were talking about eyes, we said العمى بعيونك. Okay, now today we will say العمى بقلبك. العمى بقلبك, what does it mean? عمى means blindness. العمى means the blindness. We pronounce it العمى. العمى بقلبك. بقلبك in your heart, and if you're cursing a woman, you say بقلبك, العمى بقلبك, or العمى بقلبك. When do we say this? When we are like really angry with someone and we wish blindness to their heart. But you know, when we say it, we don't actually even think of the meaning, of the implied meaning, but it's a very, very common swear word basically used in Lebanon. Most of the times we use it, for example, to say to someone like, how the hell did you do that? Or how can you do that? Most of the times when people drive, they say it, العمى بقلبك. But العمى بعيونك is a way to say like blindness to your eyes, العمى بعيونك, when you're cursing someone. And it's a way also to say you're gonna give me the evil eye. So I'm saying just العمى بعيونك, like don't give me the evil eye or something like that. Okay, so that's العمى بقلبك. And I think that's it for today. There's one more, just this is maybe like a little cultural detail. There is a church in my village. It's called El Biasua. I feel nostalgic when I talk about this because when we were kids, we used to go there to that church, and on the way out we used to buy sweets and mneish. Mneish is the like the Lebanese breakfast, that's the bread with thyme. We used to buy mneish and we used to buy juice, a juice called bonjour. Bonjour is just a brand of juice. It's like its shape is like a pyramid, so we used to drink it, and in the end we used to step on it to make it like pop. So basically all of this story is about a church called El Biasua, literally the heart of Jesus, El Biasua, that was in my village. It's a very, very beautiful church. Actually, when I go to Lebanon, I can go videotape inside and outside so you can see how nice it is. And it's built in a like in an old traditional Lebanese way, which is very, very beautiful. And this El Biasua church is not only in my village, it exists in other as well, in other places in Lebanon. Bonjour. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you tomorrow. Maybe not tomorrow, maybe the day after, in a new lesson. See you. Bye. من كل قلبي, I love you all from all my heart. Bye. Let me know, by the way, which expression you liked most, and leave it in the comment box below. See you next time. Bye bye.